y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you about how much iodine you should take as a woman and why. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knudsen, and I teach women how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine. So please subscribe, hit the notification bell so you don't miss an episode. In my last video, we talked about the symptoms of iodine deficiency. So if you missed that video, the link to that video will be down in the description box below or up in the cards above the video. But today I want to talk to you about how much iodine you should take as a woman and why. So let's get right into the topic. First of all, I want to talk to you about iodine overdose. It's almost impossible to, you know, overdose on iodine, especially since most adults, especially women, are deficient in iodine, especially if you are not somebody who eats seafood all of the time and if your digestive tract is in complete shambles, then you might as well hang up trying to absorb all of the nutrients that you need in your food in general. But that's a whole nother topic. We'll talk about that later. But most of us, like I said, are deficient, so I wouldn't worry about ODing on iodine. If you have been diagnosed with something like hyper or hypothyroidism from your doctor, then you need to talk with them about whether or not you should take iodine before you proceed to do so. But as far as ODing on iodine, it would take 200,000 micrograms of iodine in a serving. If you took that much, then you might be overdosing on iodine. So I just wanted to make that clear. I'm not telling you to go out and buy iodine either. I'm doing these videos because I want you to be able to make an informed decision. So I want to tell you what my thoughts are on it, but I want to encourage you to go out and do your own research on whether or not you think you should be taking iodine or whether or not you think it will be helping you in your particular situation. All I can tell you is that I had almost all of the symptoms of iodine deficiency, and I added iodine to my life and it helped. My clients added to their life, and over time it also helps. But you have to be the one who is responsible for your own well-being. So you decide whether or not you want to take it or not. So I want to just caution you with this. First of all, my personality has been in the past that if I was deficient in something, I would take a whole lot of it to try to build up so that I'm not deficient. I have done that with vitamin D. It actually worked well for me, but I want to caution you on, if you feel like you are iodine deficient, don't go taking a bunch of iodine to try to catch up and not be deficient. If you're going to add iodine to your lifestyle, what you should do is just start taking the dosage that your body needs per day. And so the dosage that I have researched and found to be across the board, it seems like it is the recommended amount is 12,000 mcgs, or you may see it described as 12 milligrams. So either 12 milligrams or 12,000 micrograms, that is the same dosage. So that is the amount that I take. Now, in my last video, I showed you that I take the J. Crowell's brand. This is the one that I take. And if you open it, and it has like a little dropper in there, that amount that comes up in this dropper, which if you're interested in this brand, it's linked below in the description box, is 12,000 micrograms. And the way you take it is you put some in the water and you drink it, or you can just squirt it into your mouth. It's easy to take. It doesn't really even taste like anything. Some people even take it through the skin. Now, I did talk about a patch test in the last video. It's linked below, that you can take a Q-tip, dip it into the into this bottle, into this solution, and paint it on your arm, and your body can absorb the iodine through your skin. Also, I would like to know, if you currently are taking iodine, please tell me which brand you're taking and how much you're taking. I would love to know that. But the reason I'm doing this video is because I work with women who have fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, all kinds of female reproductive issues, especially PCOS and fibroids. Those are the popular ones that I work with, mainly some endometriosis as well. But if you have female reproductive issues, it is almost guaranteed that your iodine is out of whack in your body. It just is. I have heard of circumstances where people have suffered with these types of disorders and diseases in their body, and they have gotten their iodine where it's supposed to be, and the symptoms actually went away from these disorders. Now, I don't know that you can just take iodine and just be all better. I wouldn't say that, but I think as far as like doing a lifestyle change and making sure that you add iodine and getting your iodine levels out of the tank can help reverse some of these reproductive issues, because when you get your iodine in line, it helps to balance your hormones, because when your iodine is low, your thyroid hormone is a little bit out of whack, even if it's not showing up on a blood test as being out of whack. So when you add that iodine, it just helps to balance those hormones. It helps to nourish the glands, your thyroid gland. So the parts of the body that take a tremendous amount of iodine to function properly are the breast. So if you are somebody who has fibrocystic breasts, and I talk to these women all the time, adding iodine can help with that. Also PCOS or ovarian cysts, either large ones, small ones, chocolate ones, it doesn't matter. Adding iodine can help assist in the healing of that, because iodine is needed for those organs, and also the pituitary gland and other glands in the endocrine system. It's needed for those to work properly. The iodine is needed for that. So in order for our organs to work properly, we just need to have enough iodine. As a matter of fact, any kind of deficiency in our body is going to cause our bodies to be out of whack. So overall, the reason that we need to make sure we have enough iodine is because it works, it helps our female reproductive organs work properly. So if we're low in iodine, our breast tissue will be out of whack with the fibrocystic breast. As a matter of fact, one time I was getting my annual exam, and my doctor was checking my breast or whatever, and she said, I asked her, this was years ago, I asked her, you know, did she feel any lumps? She said, oh, no more lumps than should be there for your age. I was like, what? Like, what does that mean exactly? And after that time, that's when I started putting together, like, if you have fibrocystic breasts, that's not actually normal. They say it's normal, but it's not. And iodine can help impact those cysts in your breast. That's why it's important for us to make sure we have enough. Now, I am not in any way saying that you can go and buy some iodine and start taking iodine and all of your problems are going to go away. Adding iodine along with a healthy lifestyle is how you reverse these issues. Literally. You can't just take a supplement and make stuff go away. This is one of the reasons why whenever you all ask me, well, what supplement should I take for this? Or what supplement can I take for that? And I could sit here and tell you which supplements to take. But what people do is they hear, go take this supplement, and they go take the supplement, and then nothing changes. And they're like, well, why didn't it change? Like, she said to take this and nothing happened. Well, it's because it's not about just going and taking the supplement. You have to get to the root cause of why you are having the problem in the first place. Just like in this video, we're talking about like why we need iodine as women and how much we should take. you can go and you can take iodine all day, but if you don't change your lifestyle, nothing is going to change. So in the next video that I do in this series, I'm going to talk about the root cause of iodine deficiency and actually exactly how you completely reverse the cause of having iodine deficiencies. And some of you may not even recognize how important this is, but we need these minerals in order for our bodies to function normally. And the other thing about this, I just want to say, is we really want to get to the root cause of all of these things. I'm going to be doing series on anemia, on vitamin D, because what I'm finding is everybody is deficient. They're deficient in these minerals, and it's causing our quality of life to be in the tank. And we need to be healthy so that we can function and do the things that we want in our lives, or do the things that we've been called to do. And that's why I'm talking about a lot of this stuff. In the next video, I'm going to share about the root cause of why we get these deficiencies in the first place. And I really just want to make it clear, just throwing iodine or eating iodine-rich foods is not going to correct the problem. It's a whole lifestyle change, and we got to get to the root. And the root I'm going to talk about in the next video. All right, y'all. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And also, if you want to talk to me, the link is below in the description box so you can get a free 10-minute session with me. You can also link it. It's also linked up in the card. So I will talk to you all soon. Love you. Bye-bye.